Morning, children. The union executive, the president and vice president, already you have studied. So now we will start the prime minister and council of minister. This is a list of all the prime ministers of India, and Narendra Modi, who is the present prime minister. This is from 14 he is ruling. Now, how the prime minister is appointed? In the Lok Sabha elections, which are held after every 5 years, whichever party wins the majority number of votes, the leader is invited by the president to make the government. But suppose no party gets the majority, then it's at president's discretion, means special power, whom to call. Then the president only gives them means that person, whosoever will be called, the oath of secrecy. Otherwise, qualifications, terms, all things are same, just as I told you in president. Powers and functions of the prime minister. So many things are there. First, prime minister and the president. Prime minister is the main advisor of the president. On his advice only, president summons the parliament or dissolves the Lok Sabha. On his advice only, the president appoints the council of ministers. Why? Because prime minister is the head of the party. He only advises the president on various important post appointments, especially the government. He only conveys decisions of the council of ministers, as well as ask them to reconsider anything told by the president. These all points between prime minister and the president. Now comes prime minister and the cabinet. Because majority winning party has the maximum members, so he is the leader of the cabinet. He only has the power to give or not to give the portfolios to the members. If given, if he wants to change, he only can change the portfolios. He can only select the members to be the ministers, and if he is not satisfied with the work, he can dismiss the minister. He can give the work how to do and coordinate whether the work is done properly or not, that also we will see. Now, the resignation of the prime minister means the whole party has to resign. Why? If the head is resigning, means the whole party has to resign. Means resignation of the prime minister clearly means the whole cabinet resigns. Prime minister inside the parliament. He is the leader of the Lok Sabha. If any crisis is there, he has to handle. If government has some critical issues or no minister is able to answer, so he is the spokesperson of the government. Defender of the government policies. Suppose the people are not satisfied, same thing ministers are unable to answer, then he has to defend the government policies. Intervention in case of controversial issues. Sometimes the opposition party creates such difficult situation in the houses which is unable for any of the minister to handle. In that time also, prime minister intervenes. Prime minister as the leader of the nation. Why? Because the majority number of votes his party has got, that is why he represents the whole nation. Then the opposition parties support him during any crisis. He only decides international relations. Protects and interest of the countries in international forums, means wherever he goes, he has to put the interest of the country in a better manner so that they will be able to understand. Plays a very important role during a general election, because everything has to be controlled by him only. So many powers he had, but still some limitations are there on prime minister. What are they? He has to ensure the support of his minister, means his party members as well as other parties. Coalition government, his condition is unstable, means if no single party gets the majority, then some parties, they got together and make the government. In that condition, Prime Minister has to be very visible to understand other party members are satisfied with him or not. Opposition parties always criticize him, and press and public opinion also keeps check on him. So all these are the measures which keep check on Prime Minister. Then the last part of the chapter is Union Council of Ministers. So many powers are there. Administrative powers to administer the thing means whatever legal laws were decided by the legislature, approved by the executives, now they have to amplify that. Policy making. Policy making means whatever the things, facilities, benefits have to be given to the public, they have to make policies regarding them, which is the major issue for them. Then the implementation of the policies, whether by them in the center or by the state, they have to keep a check. Coordinating the functioning of various ministers. Ministers are the heads, maybe for several departments, but there must be a coordination between the cabinet. What is the cabinet then? Cabinet is the head of all the departments. Appointments. Because they deal with the public, that is why they know who is better for the appointments. They suggest the Prime Minister for the appointments. Now the legislative powers for the cabinet. Introduction of bills. What are the bills? Issues which are discussed in Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Generally, the money bills are discussed only in the Lok Sabha, which are started by only the cabinet. Source of information. Different types of sources they have to get the information from the society through which only they make their bills. Amendment of the constitution means suppose instead of getting benefited, the people are getting harm from any of the laws. In that condition, amendment means changes can be made in the constitution by the cabinet minister. They suggest the prime minister through the president, they suggest the president through the prime minister to summon both the houses. They only prepare the special address for the president, and they only suggest the president to start the ordinances. The budget also, the finance minister pays on behalf of the president, finances of the government, and introduction of the money bills, which I have already discussed. Emergency powers, without the permission of the cabinet, nobody can issue. Now here are some differences given for the Council of Ministers and the cabinet. Cabinet is the bigger wheel, Council of Ministers is the inner wheel. They meet in daily basis, they do not. They meet with the prime ministers, they do not as a whole. So go through it properly and try to understand. Thank you.